Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. Today I just have a quick discussion. Probably others might find this discussion saying that they have a different story to tell regarding it, but let's hear me out. Okay, so you have swordtails, right? And persons have actually said this, and a lot of persons have been saying it so convincingly that there's a time now, the time is now for us to really sit down and to assess whether or not all of this is valid information. What I'm speaking about, the whole idea of persons saying that they got two female swordtail, and the two female swordtail in the, I'm not far, some go as far as saying that they have two male swordtail, but anyway, let's use the two female. They have two female swordtail, and the two female swordtails are in there for a bit, and then suddenly the two female swordtail shows as that they are pregnant, and then you see fries. Well, information shared with you, this is it. Swordtail, along with other live bearers, swordtail is a live bearer, right, can actually keep the mint of the male swordtail for up to 7 months before it decides to get pregnant. So therefore, that is not strange. So you can buy a swordtail from the pet shop. After buying the swordtail at the pet shop, you realize that the swordtail tummy doesn't look fat or anything. And like 2 months down the line, or a month down the line, you see the swordtail tummy gets big, and the swordtail actually give birth. Okay, now this is the flip side of that. Some persons say that they have two male swordtail because two of them have the sword at the end of the tail, right? And the two male swordtail are in the aquarium, and after a couple months, well, it's as if they turn around and they say, hey, female in here, I'm going to be a female and I reproduce, right? And then suddenly the female, suddenly one of the swordtail, which is a male, actually gets pregnant, shed the tail, and becomes a woman. I don't believe that this is a valid statement to make. I think that this is not true. However, there are some rationale that could explain what have happened. One, just like how you have persons have been, I call it hermaphrodites. Yeah, you have hermaphrodites as humans, where persons have both sexes, male and female. Chances are you might have a 1 in a million chance that you might just have a swordtail or a live bearer that is like that. So therefore, the whole idea of that the male getting pregnant is as a result of that, because the dominant gene, the dominant sex organ is the female, right? The thing is, sometimes you get a live bearer, but the live bearer don't show whether it is female or male until it is like in a juvenile stage or even past, because it just looks like a female, fat like a female, it looks like a female. And you know, sometimes you might have a man, this is the funny part, right? You might have a man who have a little thing, you might have a man who have a big thing, right? You might have a fish that have the same, right? So you can't really identify the male sex organ by virtue of looking at the gonadinium, the male thing, right? Because it's very fine, right? So you have anomalies as far as fish development is concerned. So therefore, this is one of the things that I think as fish keepers we all need to look at, to see or to consider or to discuss whether or not this argument is valid. Let me know what you think, because I've had questions from persons in the pet shop, persons coming to me purchasing live bearers, students in my class asking me the question whether or not a swordtail can actually transform itself from a male to a female, from a female to a male, so as to reproduce and to keep the species going. Let me know what you think. Have an awesome day. Bye bye for now. Cool.